Today we are going to see the half wave rectifier with the filter. Now this is your half wave rectifier. The filter has been applied. Now if I apply the input this way, you are going to get the output this way. Means it will be starting to come to zero, but because of the discharging R and C, now the capacitor has charged in this cycle. Now when we'll be discharging, because the time duration of because R and C time delay is more, and it will take much time to discharge. And again, when positive peak is coming, it will be like this. Means it will try to match with the DC. Means actually we wanted the DC. That is why we are giving capacitor in parallel of load so that we can get DC. Now, if you see with this effect, the calculated value of ripple by the literature, it is 1 by root 2 root 3 FRC. F the frequency that we are operating, because when capacitor has come into effect, we need to go to with the frequency. And the R and this C, and we have taken 220 kilo ohm, and frequency we have set around 378 hertz, and a capacitor 4.7 nanofarad. Now we are going to check all this by multimeter, and then we are going to calculate ripple factor, and we are also going to calculate the ripple factor by BAC by BDC, that we will get it from DSO. And we are going to calculate the efficiency with this improved version VAC, that efficiency VDC, that VRMS square by VDC square. This we are going to calculate that efficiency, and we are going to go on the circuit. Now here we will learn how to calculate that, measure the capacitor. This is the two place where we will keep the capacitor. And now we will move our knob to capacitor mode. Now this is your capacitor mode. Now let's change it to capacitor mode. Now this has come to capacitor mode. And if you want to see the reading, it is around 5.2 nanofarad if you see. But we have taken the, this capacitor was rated around 4.7 nanofarad, but it is coming around 5.2 nanofarad. See, whatever the rated, you must not get. See, it is increasing. Means we will taking for the calculator 5.3 nanofarad. This is how we calculate the capacitor. Now we will calculate the resistance. If you want to calculate the resistance, this is the resistance that we are calculating. Now yeah, if I tap over here, I see it is around 225 kilo ohm. That rated was 220 kilo ohm. Now we are going to chart this resistance. Now this is the output with the normal diode and your resistance. Now I am going to connect the capacitance across this one. Now if you see, the output is going to change. This is the output that we are going to get. Means it is trying to come to the DC. Now we are going to calculate all the value. Now if you see, the maximum input that has been applied 11.2 and minus 10.8, that it must be equal. That is because of function generator, it is not equal. Now here the mean is 5.88 volt. DC of this component is 5.8. If I remove capacitor, you will see that DC has decreased. Now let me remove the capacitor. Now if you see, the DC has decreased. Now when I insert capacitor, the DC value will increase. This is what it is increasing, the DC value. Now if you see, check the cycle RMS, it is around 6.47, and now it is increasing 6.48. Now if I want to calculate the AC directly, now what we need to do, if I want to calculate the AC, now I just need to tap the channel 2, and there I must do AC coupling. If I have done the AC coupling, again go to measure. Here this value will show, this RMS value is going to show with the AC. Now here if you see, the AC is 2.62, and if you see the DC of this is around 0, which must be because we have just, because of that AC coupling, we just wanted to know how much AC is present. This is the AC that we have present. Now if I remove that capacitor, now if you see, the AC value will be increased. Now see, AC value has increased drastically. Now I am inserting that capacitor, and you will see AC has decreased. Now see, AC has decreased to, and come to 2.62 around. Let it saturate. Now again going to DC coupling. Now this is your DC coupling. Now I want to show one more thing. If I remove this capacitance, and I insert this electrolytic capacitance of higher magnitude around 100 microfarad, now you are going to get a perfect DC. Now if you measure, your RMS and mean will be equal. It means efficiency is going to go to 1. This is all because this capacitor is of higher magnitude. And when you insert a capacitor with a lower magnitude, this is the lower magnitude I am inserting, you will see the discharging is happening. And with the higher this one, you are going to get, because it is taking too long time to discharge. Now this is all about the half-wave rectifier with the filter. Now if you see, we have set the frequency to 378 Hz. Now we are going to calculate all this. Now if you see the calculation, actually with the rating it was this one, but actually we got 225 kilo ohm, and it is what, 5.3 nanofarad. By this formula we calculated around 0.64, and theoretically it was this one, and because of filter it is coming to this one theoretically. But practically, if you take BAC by BDC, BAC that we have taken from DSO, and BDC is 5.88, it is 0.44, means there is drastic change in ripple factor, means AC component is decreasing, and this is because of filter. Now if you see efficiency, the formula that I have written, it was wrong. BRMS by BDC square, it will be BDC that is that we wanted, BDC by RL, that because BDC that we wanted because of rectification. And what we are getting, BRMS by RL, BRMS square by RL, this is the what we are getting. And because of this, if you do BDC by BRMS square, BDC we got it around 5.88 square divided by 6.40 square. This is the BRMS we got. We are getting 84.4% efficiency. That is because of filter. And theoretically, it was 40.5% without filter. Now, this is all about the half-wave rectifier with filter.